One fine evening at about daylight savings time, I decided to take my dog Nipper for a walk. I grabbed his leash and we were out the door. Nipper slipped happily as his legs carried him along at a pace I could barely keep up with. We glided along past the houses on our block, and presently we arrived at the first scheduled stop on our appointed rounds. Nipper slipped the hydrant excitedly from top to bottom, inspecting every square millimeter of its surface with the dedication reserved for only the most important person who matters. He aimed the once over, and the twice over. After much deliberation, Nipper decided that all was in order. He lifted his leg and, his personal business attended to, Nipper decided it was time to resume our walk. We headed off down the sidewalk at a brisk pace, Nipper bouncing along now happily free of his burden. We floated along past white picket fences, driveways, and mailboxes. There didn't seem to be anything out of the ordinary, but as we neared the corner, Nipper began straining in his leash with all his might. He began snorting and barking, and thick white foam formed instantly around his savagely snapping tusks. I struggled to control the leash that was thrashing around violently in my hands. I couldn't imagine what was making him so homicidally agitated, when from around the corner appeared the postman. Without so much as a second's hesitation, Nipper lunged. I was hauled face first to the pavement and the leash exploded from my hands. There was a cyclone blur of man and beast and the sounds of frenzied gnashing teeth, tearing cloth, and hideous piercing screams. The postman made one desperate grab for his can of mace before his arm was wrenched from his socket and thrown useless into the street. Nipper swarmed on the postman like a school of piranhas, carrying huge chunks of flesh right from the bone, surrounded by a blizzard of blue from the shred of uniform. It was only a matter of seconds before the hapless postman was reduced to an unrecognizable mass of gently quivering pulp. I pulled Nipper away from the carnage so we could continue our leisurely stroll. Nipper trotted along triumphantly, his head held high with me in tow. We zipped past immaculately clipped lawns and hedges, leaving a trail of frequent blood spots that glistened moistly. We'd gone almost a block without incident, but as we neared the next corner, Nipper began straining at his leash with all his might. He started snarling and barking, and a thick white foam formed instantly around his savage and savage jaws as I struggled to control the leash and thrashing around violently in my hands. I couldn't imagine what was making him so homicidally agitated, but from around the corner appeared... Mahler. Now, Mahler was the biggest, meanest, toughest, most evil dog on the whole block. He was 100% muscle and bad disposition, and more than a match for 10 or 15 Nippers. He sidled right up to Nipper, sniffed him, and stopped. He let out a low, throaty growl, and his chops curled back to reveal rows of razor-sharp teeth and powerful, bone-crushing jaws. Nipper was nonplussed. Without so much as a second's hesitation, Nipper lunged. Fresh from his recent victory over the hapless postman, Nipper launched himself finally straight at Marlowe's snout. All 7.5 pounds of him landed with full force and snapping jaws right onto Marlowe's nose. In no time at all, Nipper was tearing huge chunks of meat right from the bone. Marlowe bellowed in agony as he was mauled and mangled from head to tail. The one-sided battle raged for only a few seconds as Marlowe struggled unsuccessfully to escape, but was hampered by the geysers of blood gushing from nearly every part of his rapidly diminishing body. It was only a matter of seconds before Marlowe was reduced to an unrecognizable mass of crimson pulsating mush. As Nipper backed away from the carnage, who should suddenly appear from around the corner but Sheba? She bumped and ground and strutted her stuff for all her pedigreed worth. Every part of her flounced seductively, she pranced down the sidewalk with her head held high. She breezed right by as if we weren't even there and stopped just a few feet away to preen. Nipper's interest was piqued. Without so much as an introductory sniff, Nipper lunged. Decided it was time to call it a night. I grabbed his leash, passed it back onto his flea collar, turned him around in the direction of home, and we started to walk back as the sun set scenically in the west.
Thank you.
solution to his problem. What's the evil?
Yeah. Coming to him. I got a dollar, says that's him down here in that phone booth. He's waiting for me to go get a push-up, and that'll be it for me. Well, no! Oh, I know he don't think I know what's on his mind. But I do. I know what his mucus is up to. Behind all that darn purple skin, I do. It's up to splitting this guy open and seeing what I got. But that ain't none of his darn purple business. I'll show him what I got. Wagon. It's full of machine guns. I can see him shining while he has a smoker do. He's listening to AM radio with a gun in each purple worm. He's waiting for this guy here. Oh, I'm not in for his game, no. This guy's got a big, fat, pasty woman upstairs to pass the time with. But I'm keeping a lookout, and these hip boots are staying on. Because if that guy tries to get me, there's gonna be blood on my boots and slime in the air!
There ain't no lot of them, Mitchell. There's a whole lot of commies. There's a whole lot of mommies. There's a whole lot of bombies. There's a whole lot of Tommies. There's a whole lot of zombies. There's a whole lot of zombies. Yes, 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 butts of heads, hands of holes, teeth of beef, lots of guts. You can't speak granny, you can't think your nanny, the bobbly dimension. You can't lick your navel, the bobbly dimension. You can't smoke your bagel, the bobbly dimension. You can't lick your nostril, the bobbly dimension. You can't poke your gospel, the bobbly dimension. You can't munch your kooka, the bobbly dimension. You can't crunch your nougat, the bobbly dimension. You can't eat your corn chips, the bobbly dimension. You can't bang your horse chips, the bobbly dimension. You can't do your girdle. Can't think of turtle. Bobby dimension. Not the Bobby dimension.